Hello, my name is Joe. If you're new here, I am learning Spanish very proactively. I have been on and off learning German for most of my life, and I also dabble in Korean and American Sign Language. So you could definitely say that languages are a major interest of mine, and so I have collected quite a few books over the years. Primarily, I think maybe if you live in the United States, you'll be interested in where I find books. Mostly if you go into a mainstream bookstore here, you are going to see mostly English books and a small Spanish section and then a small, you know, language learning section. But if you want to find fun native books to read in another language, then let's discuss where I have gotten mine. So these are the books that I have just sitting on my desk. My current read is Catching Fire. This series I ordered online from second sale, I believe. I will link all of my favorite used book sites in the description, all of which shouldn't be owned by Amazon. I do double check that because you do have to be careful sometimes. Like Abe Books, for example, is owned by Amazon. We got Porg here. These are my two Spanish reference books that I use when I'm studying. They're both older Teach Yourself editions. I have these two that I have started and am taking a break from. One of them is Charlotte's Web. This was a Christmas gift. And this is The Voyage of the Dawn Treader. I ordered several books from this series, The Chronicles of Narnia, after reading The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe last year. This is a little children's book that was also a Christmas gift. It is a German book, Ein wilder Tag im Zoo. So these are my Spanish unread books. For my English books, I separate my unread and previously read books, and so I did the same with Spanish since I am actively studying that right now. I have two Haruki Murakami books, De qué hablo cuando hablo de correr, which is his memoir, what I talk about when I talk about running, I don't know. And then Tokyo Blues, which is Norwegian Wood, apparently. I have this book, which is actually a bilingual book in Spanish and German, which is very cool. So it is poems, and they have the Spanish on one side and the German on the other. So this was a half-price book find. Probably a very large amount of these books will be from half-price books. If you are not familiar, it is a chain bookstore that buys and sells used books. There are a lot of them, but I know that they do not exist in every state. But they are a great place to find foreign language books and educational books. They have many, many languages there usually, but sometimes, you know, you'll go and they have very boring book options in your language, but you can definitely find some gems, and they usually have a lot that aren't just like Spanish, French, German also. They have a lot of Asian languages, and yeah. This is Winnie the Pooh. I believe I ordered this on a used book site a very long time ago, sometime when I first thought I was going to try to learn Spanish, and then I realized that the actual Winnie the Pooh books, which I did read when I was a kid, so it's not like I didn't know this, but I totally forgot that the actual books are, you know, not for like babies, you know? This book I got at the same time that I got the Haruki Murakami books, and that was at a bookstore called, that was a bookstore whose name I have forgotten that I will put on screen. We were traveling and just happened to stop into this massive used bookstore that sold toys and comics and books and everything, and they had a fairly sizable Spanish section, and most of the books were like 75 cents, so I got a bunch of books from there. This one, The Brief and Wonderful Life of Oscar Wao, doesn't look great to me, but we'll see. La Casa in Mango Street. The first Harry Potter, I believe I ordered this at the same time as Winnie the Pooh a very long time ago. It was kind of an inspirational thing. The other two Harry Potter books that I have in Spanish, which are the second and the seventh books, I got at half-price books at assorted times. An abridged educational version of Don Quixote. The Narnia series I ordered online. Same with the entire Hunger Games series graphic novel for the first Percy Jackson book. This is my Spanish read shelf. I do have a couple more that I have read that are loaned out to people right now, but the graphic novel for La Magia del Orden, or the Life-Changing Magic of Tidying Up by Marie Kondo. I have the first two books in The Chronicles of Narnia. The graphic novel for A Wrinkle in Time. I have Goodnight Moon. I have these two graphic novels, which I believe I ordered on Amazon when I very, very first started learning Spanish. And these are actually pretty good. They are fairy tale retellings. I have the graphic novel for Pride and Prejudice. The first collection of leñadoras, or lumberjanes, comics. Traditional Spanish nursery rhyme book that I got at a library sale that I have never actually looked at. I should do that. I don't know why it's on the shelf. Removing that one. Magalina was a beautiful graphic novel. Quite difficult to read because it is mostly magical things that I don't know the vocabulary for. The graphic novels I did order new with a gift card. Okay, so this is my German, mostly like fiction shelf. I don't have my German books separated into read and unread. They, spoiler alert, would almost all be unread. This is about German slang and profanity and such. It's not something I would buy now because I don't think you can really learn how to use that kind of stuff properly from reading it in a book, but you know. This is a little picture book about farm animals. I have read this one. The Adventures of Sherlock Holmes. The Little Prince I actually bought in Germany. My cat has been chewing, apparently. The Little Princess. An Agatha Christie book. Alice in Wonderland, this is a parallel, like a bilingual English on one side, German on the other. Catcher in the Rye. German Harry Potter, the second book I actually bought in Germany. I wanted to get the first one, but they didn't have it. Funny story, I actually successfully asked the lady in German whether they had the first book, and she responded in German, which is great, and I was listening to what she said, and it took a second for me to understand. And by the time I understood, she had already realized, based on the look on my face, that I was not a native German speaker and had said it all again in English. So it was good because she understood my German and responded in German, but then it was bad because I wasn't able to respond fast enough. And then the first book I bought here in the States, because yeah, I wanted the first book more so than the second book. I have no idea what this book is. I got this at a, like, take one, leave one bookshelf at a hostel. This is cool. This is a fairy tale book, and it is in old German font. I'm not really a collector, but this is more of a collector item, but I would still read it maybe someday. Anne of Green Gables. Hannah and the Magical Animals. The Lost Magic of the Unicorns, I think. You really never know what you're going to find at half-price books, I'm telling you. And then the first Chronicles of Narnia book, I did order this one online after I read it in Spanish. I wanted to read it in German. And lastly for this shelf, we have the full works of Rilke. I just bought this the other day, actually, at Half Price Books. It was too good to pass up. It was like $6 or $7, I think. And yeah, even though I'm not actively studying German, I do want to get back to it. And so this was just really cool. So this is kind of my educational bookshelf mostly. So finishing up with German, we have Complete German, some older teacher self-reference books, German Tutor, and a German English dictionary. This was my mom's when she studied German in college. For Spanish, we have a compact dictionary, Madrigal's Magic Key to Spanish, which is very similar to like the Michelle Thomas or language transfer method, but I do think that works better spoken, and so I'm not sure that I'm going to go through this, but I haven't gotten rid of it yet. Easy Spanish, honestly, I could get rid of. Never look at that. I have some, like, cheat sheets for German. And then I have these two picture books in German. I have actually had these since I was a child. Kleiner Eisbär kommt bald wieder and Ein Esel geht nach Bethlehem. I have read these. They are very, very cute, particularly this polar bear one. And then my only physical Korean book is this Korean Stories for Language Learners, and I did just buy this at Barnes & Noble. So those are all of my non-English language books. Hopefully I was able to give you some ideas of where to look for books if you need those ideas, and if not, then hopefully it was just entertaining. If you would like to follow along with my language learning journey, then subscribe. I do try to do at least a monthly update on my language learning, along with reading and other things that I find interesting. So, thanks, and I will see you next time.